This is not coronavirus, it's just pollen. So, my scanning electron microscope, brand new SEC SNE Alpha. Today I'll show you how it works, what is inside, and why tabletop electron microscopes are super useful in almost every lab. Of course, we'll capture some images of different objects, so stay tuned. It comes in a huge wooden box with overall weight more than 240 kilos. Special handles for lifting the system are just brilliant. It took some time to set all the parts, but actually it's pretty easy. All you need to do is just connect a few cables, vacuum lines with standard lock mechanism and plug in an ordinary USB cable to PC. No special tools or equipment required. Okay, here we are. This is the main unit. It's a microscope with a chamber. Today we are going to have some fun with it, but first of all, let me show you what do we have inside. This is a precision 5-axis stage with a stub mount on top. These metal plates are called stubs. We have different stubs and different stages, for example for tilting mount, but we can tilt the stub inside of the chamber using axis called T in the software. And we always mount samples on top of the stub using the conductive tape. In the chamber you can see secondary electron and backscattered electron detectors. Also, we have a port for EDS detector installation, but spectroscopy is the long story, so we will dive into it in the future episodes. No buttons at all, everything motorized except of aperture knob. It's manual but pretty solid and easy to use. I was also impressed with the SEC logo, which is actually a vacuum progress bar. Love it. We have an iron sputter coater nearby. We need to coat unconductive specimens with a nano layer of metal or carbon. In our case, it can be gold or platinum. Carbon coaters are different. This coating prevents the sample from being charged by electron beam. In this MCP100 coater, we can control the coating thickness only by coating time. This old-style timer is absolutely ideal for this. I think pollen grains is a perfect sample for a demonstration of this microscope. So let's put some double-sided carbon tape on the stub and try to find something interesting. Pollen is a poor conductor of electricity and will become charged during analysis, so we need to coat it with a thin layer of metal. 1.5 minutes is more than enough. We need to perform stage align and mount the stub on the microscope stage. We have a special caliper gauge to measure the size of the mounted sample. And we need to type this data to the software just to avoid collision between the sample and the detectors. Navigation camera is a useful option and it helps us with XY positioning. Okay, we're ready to go. Let's close the chamber and initialize vacuum. Press the start button to start the column and we're in a fast scan live view mode. Let's make some adjustment of magnification and focus. By the way, I'll prepare a video about tabletop SEM adjustment. It will be available via link in the description soon. Let's check the brightness and contrast. And finally, resolution, scan speed and scan. I'll speed it up a little bit. Our first scan. As you can see, we can clearly see all the field of our specimen, everything is sharp and clear. Depth of field is huge and we can clearly see something like 3D image. But let's find some particular pollen grain, for example this one. We need to scroll the necessary magnification, make some adjustments with aperture and stigmation, find a nice spot size and boom! Pretty impressive. And we can measure everything here. This tiny spot is less than 200 nanometers. Let's add some tilt to the stage and try to find other grains. The microscope will prevent any collisions inside the chamber and automatically apply changes to the working distance and Z position. I prepared a stub with the ordinary objects from our everyday life. Can you guess what these objects are? Let's try. Thank you. Okay, I hope it was interesting for you. Please subscribe to my channel if you like microscopy. We will dive into different areas of microscopy here. Have an absolutely fantastic day. See you soon.